wind up your radios. Dimension from the bed night. It's time once again for the Dr. Demento Show, coming to you from under the strawberry trees of woo-woo wonderful Westwood. And we're right here with Lucky Lindsay and Crazy Quill. And 2 hours of mad music and crazy comedy. Some sounds you never heard before on the radio. And who knows, probably some sounds you'll never hear again. So without further ado, let's get the party going with the Blues Brothers.
One from 1957 by the Chips. Do that again. You know, people, the other day, I had a Whiz sandwich. Oh, yeah. Yeah. A Whiz sandwich is the kind of a sandwich where you do have 2 slices of bread, either rye or white or pumpernickel, and you sincerely wish you had some meat. Ball, ball, ball. You know, that same day, and this will give you an idea of how down I was, I did have a Ricochet biscuit. Oh, yeah. Well, now, a Ricochet biscuit is that kind, that particular brand of biscuit, that's supposed to bounce off the wall back in your mouth. People, if it don't bounce back, you will go hungry. Bow, bow, bow. Now the other day, it wasn't the same day, but I did have a cool water sandwich and a Sunday go to meat and bun, which means I had a watermelon. I took a little lady to church. Bow, bow, bow. Now I ask you people, what do you all want for nothing? A rubber biscuit? Bow, bow,
Jay Canalwood on the Dr. Demento Show with Rubber Biscuit, brand new version of that from the Best of the Blues Brothers album. Hey, give us a call, Dimensions and Amentites. Request your favorite song. Who knows, maybe your call will be the one that pushes your special favorite up onto the Funny Five. Call us at area code 213-652-8028. It's a lot of fun, and if we use your voice on the air, you win a Dr. Demento t-shirt. So please dial carefully, and you might want to do it now while the rates are real low. Area code 213-652-8028. Now, what is this I see in the little room outside my surgery? Is it Olivia Newton-Fig? No, it's Sulu.
You don't know how long it's been since I had a check. My heart beats faster than you would expect. And while you're at it, hon, I got a real stiff neck. And all of this is making me a nervous wreck. I'm dying to know if I can pass the test. I love it every time I get my tongue depressed. And when you're oh so close to listening to my chest, I feel a cold sensation when it's placed on. talk, won't you listen to my chest, babe, and you will hear my body talk. A physical, physical, examine me, a physical, press that thing against my chest, and you will hear my body talk. Body talk, won't you listen to my chest, babe, and you will hear my body talk. It isn't every day that I remove my clothes. You say you'll do it to me from my head to my toes, but when you get a physical, that's how it goes. I found you in the yellow pages, lucky I chose you. I'm quite a patient, even though I feel real dumb. I'm trying not to move on the table. I waited for an hour and you still haven't come. It's 6 o'clock, I wonder if you're able. I still haven't got my physical, physical. Examine me, a physical. Won't you press that thing against my chest and listen to my body talk, my heartbeat. Won't you listen to my chest, babe? I really need, I need a physical, physical. Examine me, a physical. Press that thing against my chest and listen to my body talk, body talk. Won't you listen to my chest, babe? 'Cause I need a physical, physical. Examine me, a physical.
Oh, Sulu, what a test of my Hippocratic oath. And who's this? Sophia Loren! And Peter Sellers in the Dr. Demento Show.
Oh, Doctor, I'm in trouble.
Well, goodness gracious me.
For every time a certain man is standing next to me, a flash comes to my face and my pulse begins to race. It goes boom boody boom boody boom boody boom boody boom boody boom boody boom 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 boody boom boody boom boody boom.
Well, goodness gracious me. How often does this happen? When did the trouble start? You see, my stethoscope is bobbing to the throbbing of your heart.
What kind of man is he to create this allergy? It goes boom boody boom boody boom boody boom boody boom boody boom boody boom 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 boody boom boody boom boody boom.
Well, goodness gracious me. From New Delhi to Darjeeling, I have done my share of healing, and I've never yet been beaten or outboxed. I remember that with one jab of my needle in the Punjab, how I cleared up beriberi and the dreaded dysentery. But your complaint has got me really foxed.
Oh, oh, doctor, touch my fingers.
Well, goodness gracious me.
You may be very clever, but however can't you see? My heart beats much too much at a certain tender touch. It goes boom booty boom booty boom booty boom booty boom booty boom booty boom boom boom.
Like it.
Boom booty boom booty boom booty boom.
Well, goodness gracious me. Can I see your tongue? Nothing the matter with it. Put it away, please.
Maybe it's my back.
Maybe it is.
Shall I lie down?
Yes. My initial diagnosis rules out measles and thrombosis, sleeping sickness, and as far as I can tell, influenza, inflammation, whooping cough, and night starvation. And you'll be so glad to hear that both your eyeballs are so clear that I can positively swear that you are well.
Put two and two together.
Four.
If you have eyes to see,
yes.
The face that makes my pulses race is right in front of me.
Oh, there is nothing I can do, for my heart is jumping too.
Oh,
we go boom boody boom boody boom. Boom boody boom boody boom boody boom boody boom 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 boody boom boody boom boody boom.
Goodness gracious,
how audacious.
Goodness gracious,
how flirtatious.
Goodness gracious,
it is me.
It is you.
I'm sorry, it is us.
I know a girl around the block, and I bet her face would stop a clock. But when it comes to fellows, why, she's got a flock, 'cause she's the AIDS wonder of the world. She's got a, by George, that would open your eyes. She's got a, my world, that could win her a prize. And when she, with her, you can ask all the guys, why, she's the AIDS wonder of the world. She's got a nose, it's really flat, 300 pounds, so fat. The other girls will tell you she's this and she's that, but she's the eighth wonder of the world. She's got a, by George, that would open your eyes. She's got a, by a world, that could win her a prize. And when she, with her, you can ask all the guys why she's the eighth wonder of the world. The other girl, they brag a lot of fancy clothes and who knows what. But still I know they're wishing they'd had what she's got, cause she's the eighth wonder of the world. She's got a, by George, that would open your eyes. She's got a, by world, that could win her a prize. And when she's with her, you can ask all the guys why she's the eighth wonder of the world. I know a chap who took her out to see what it was all about. I know he found the answer when I heard him shout why she's the eighth wonder of the world. I tell you, she's got a, by George, that would open your eyes. She's got a, by world, that could win her a prize. And when she with her, you can ask all the guys why she's the eighth wonder of the world. I tell you, here she comes now. Quickly, Harry, slam the door. Too late. Now we're in for it.
Larry starts with a rowdy relic from 1958 on the Dr. Demento Show, The Eighth Wonder of the World, and Peter Sellers and Sophia Loren. Goodness gracious me.
Betcha I can put a watermelon in my mouth.
That's impossible.
Our delicious has a brand new flavor.
Way out, watermelon.
The ultimate bubble has the ultimate flavor.
Hey, watermelon Bubblicious bubblegum. Soft, juicy.
And big bubbles like Bubblicious strawberry, orange, and banana.
Mmm, delicious. You really can put a watermelon in your mouth.
Not so impossible.
The ultimate bubble has the ultimate flavor.
Ah, the party's hearty here under the Swampberry trees. More dementia almost instantaneously.
Dr. Demento, Dr. Demento, Dr. Demento.
Hi, Doctor. This is Cindy Wilson calling from Lakewood, Iowa. I want to learn all about the birds and the bees. Can you play it for me, Doctor? The Birds and the Bees by Ronan Martin.
You gonna take a vacation?
No, I don't have time.
Where are you going? What do you mean you don't have time?
Well, you've got to get around, you know. I mean, I have certain obligations.
Well, no, but it's a great time of the year. You know, the spring of the year, you can get out and study wildlife. You know, out there where everything's wild, man.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, that's
my dressing room was pretty wild.
No, I'm talking about that virgin territory.
Yeah, that's it. How'd you know?
No. Up there in the hills, you can see some wonderful things up in those woods. Oh, yeah, that camping out is a lot of fun. You see a lot of things that you don't run into ordinarily.
Yeah.
And if you get interested in that kind of thing, boy, it can mean a lot to you. Like, you like to watch birds.
Huh?
They have whole societies, you know, for bird watching.
How do you go about that?
What do you mean? You just lie out in a field.
That's a good start.
No, you lie out there with a strong pair of glasses, and you can study things, boy, and you'll learn about nature. Oh. But a lot of guys start very young when they do that.
Doing what?
Studying nature.
Oh.
Like when you were a kid, your mother told you about the birds and the bees?
Well, that was my sex education.
Yeah, I know, but you see...
She told me about the birds and the bees when I was in the bathtub with my rubber duck.
Well, did she?
Yeah.
There
I was there with the rubber duck, floating it around.
And she
told me about the chickens.
The chicken?
Yeah.
Oh, the story of the egg.
No, before the egg.
What do you mean before the
egg? Well, the hen gets in the corner and the rooster comes along, va-va-boom. Boy, I understood that pretty good.
That part you understood.
Oh, the rubber duck went flying.
Oh, yeah. Well, you mean...
But to this day, I can't figure flowers.
What do you mean you can't figure flowers?
How do flowers fool around?
Oh, come on. Flowers don't fool around.
Come on. I figure under the ground, they're going, hey, baby.
You mean nobody ever told you about pollination?
Is that where stuff's floating in the water?
No, that's pollution.
Oh, pollution.
No, pollination. Flowers have to be pollinated. The male flower has pollen, which has to be sent to the female flower.
Hmm.
Now, if you have a whole field of flowers, and the male flower's way over in one corner of the field, and the female's over on the other side, how do you think that pollen gets over there?
I figure in the middle of the night, the male flower gets up.
No. There are four ways for a flower to be pollinated.
Whee!
Four ways. One way is by the wind.
The wind?
That's right.
With the flower?
Certainly. The
You're
wind blows
kidding.
Across the top of the flower, and that flower has a long, hairy stigma. And it has...
You're putting me...
No. It has very dry pollen.
Oh.
And when, well, that's good.
Is it good?
Well, certainly, because the wind picks the pollen up and scatters it.
By George.
That's the wind. Now, some flowers are pollinated by insects.
Insects?
Insects. That flower has sticky pollen.
Sticky pollen.
Some flowers are pollinated by hand. There are some flowers...
Hold it! What's this one by hand?
Well, that's like a gardener.
The gardener fools around with the flowers?
No, no, he's not fooling around. He has them in a hothouse.
Sure he has.
He goes by with a little brush.
He's a dirty old man.
No, he's not either. The man is a horticulturist.
I'll bet he is.
And that's what he does. Now then, some flowers, of course, use self-pollination.
Whoops.
Well, certainly the perfect flower has both male and female parts.
Ain't that handy.
If there's no outside agency to do the job for him, it certainly is.
I guess so.
But the most interesting and one of the most fascinating stories in nature is the relationship between the bee and the flower.
The bee fools around with the flower?
No, the bee doesn't even know it's pollinating.
You're kidding.
No.
You see, I've been that drunk myself sometimes.
I mean, for instance, you see, the bee, in the first place, doesn't know about the pollen. He's after the nectar.
Oh.
The nectar in the flower.
Oh.
And the, remember now, the pollen is sticky.
Yeah.
And the bee has furry little feet.
Does that help?
Well, of course it helps.
Well, I'll wear my socks
I mean, it helps in this way. When the bee lights on the tip of the pistil...
The what?
It's a part of the flower.
Oh.
When he lights on the tip of the pistil, he's there to get the nectar.
Oh.
But the pollen sticks to his feet. Now, he'll leave this flower and stop at another flower. And the pollen he's picked up on his feet from this one, he'll leave a little on that one.
Huh.
Yeah.
And that makes other flowers?
Well, he'll cover a whole field.
Well, that's what happened to Donald at the picnic.
What happened to Donald at the picnic?
He pollinated three girls.
No, he didn't pollinate anybody.
He had to move to Pittsburgh.
Well, I don't care where. Well, we didn't pollinate. Have you ever seen a beehive?
Sure.
You know what's inside a beehive?
A lot of little compartments.
Little compartments.
And the female bee's in there, and the male bee flies home at night and says, hey, baby.
No. That's a honeycomb in there.
Yeah.
And the bee we're talking about doesn't have any sex.
What?
That's right. He is a worker.
Yeah?
His whole job is work, work, work. That's all he does. Now, everybody in the bee society has a job to
After he works, couldn't he?
No. I tell you, he has no sex.
That's terrible.
Is neuter. He's neither male nor female.
Well, make up his mind.
Well, no. The bees are produced from the queen.
Yeah.
The queen bee lives 15, 20 years, produces thousands of bees.
Huh.
Only has romance once.
She didn't like it, huh?
No, it isn't that she didn't like it.
She ought to try it again.
Her job is to produce...
I didn't like avocados when I...
That hasn't anything to do with it. It's a matter of instinct with the bees. You see, have you ever heard of the nuptial flight?
Is that United or...
The nuptial flight of the queen bee.
Yeah.
On the day of the nuptial flight, the drones... I didn't tell you about the drones. Those are male. You don't see them except on this one day. See, they stay in the hive. The other bees take care of them.
Uh-huh.
But on the day of the nuptial flight, the young virgin queen leaves the hive.
Yeah.
And she starts into life on her own, and all the drones take off after
her. They all go.
The whole gang of them go after
her.
But only one of them gets her.
He nails her.
Well... Maybe a more poetic way to put it. But you see, this, he becomes what they call the prince consort to the queen.
Yeah.
And the marriage takes place while they're in the air.
Huh?
I say, they consummate the marriage while they're in flight.
While they're flying along?
Right.
You're kidding.
Yeah. No.
The only way to fly.
You want to find out what happens now, I'll tell you, because it's a fascinating process. Do you know what she does the minute it's over?
She says, light me a cigarette.
No. The minute it's over,
happens to me.
She is so anxious to get started on this new life that she just takes off.
She leaves him?
So fast that she always takes part of him with her when she goes.
The hell you say.
That's right. Now, she'll get
off. Which part?
His reproductive part.
Ah!
Rips it out.
Why, that's terrible.
Well, it's all over for him.
I guess so.
No, he's done his job.
That's his job?
That's it.
He's a dummy.
What are you talking about?
Should have nailed her in the flower bed with Donald.
Now the queen will go on and never have romance again.
I guess not. The word gets out. Look out for Helen. She'll grab it and run.
You don't understand anything I've told you, for heaven's sake.
Where do you get all these dirty books?
They're not dirty books. You read them in biology class. How are you going to learn about life if you don't read and study?
Well, you don't learn about life by reading, let me tell you. You learn about life by living it.
Well, you don't observe, is your
problem. I don't, huh? Yeah. Ho, ho, ho. Last night I observed.
What'd you
observe? You wouldn't believe what I saw.
What?
At a bar. Why, two guys sitting there hugging and kissing and holding hands. It was terrible.
No kidding.
I turned to the fellow I was dancing with. I said,
oh, come on. Get...
Rowan and Martin with the birds and the bees. Ah, it seems like only yesterday that Rowan and Martin's Laugh-In was the hippest thing on TV. And talking about being hip, there's a fellow named Dave Frischberg who just came out with a new album called the Dave Frischberg Songbook, and he's got a great song about being hip.
I'm hip. I'm no square. I'm alert, I'm awake, I'm aware. I am always on the scene, making the rounds, digging the sounds. I buy People magazine, 'cause I'm hip. Like Dig, I'm in step. When it was hip to be hep, I was hep. I don't blow, but I'm a fan. But look at me swing, ring-a-ding-ding. I even call my girlfriend man, 'cause I'm hip. And every Saturday night, with my suit buttoned tight and my suede's on, I'm getting my kicks, digging arty French flicks with my shades on. 'Cause I'm too much, I'm a gas. I am anything but middle class. When I hang around the band, popping my thumbs, digging the drums, squares don't seem to understand why I flip. Then I hip, like I'm hip. Oh, I'm hip, oh, I'm hip, yes, I'm hip. Enjoy any joint where there's jive. I'm on top of every trend. Look at me go, vodeo-do. Sammy Davis knows my friend, I'm so hip. I'm hip, but not weird. Like you notice, I don't wear a beard. Beards were in, but now they're out. They had their day, now they're passé. Just ask me if you're in doubt, 'cause I'm hip. Oh, I'm hip. Now I'm deep into Zen meditation and macrobiotics. And as soon as I can, I intend to get into narcotics. 'Cause I am cool as a cuke. I'm a cat, I'm a card, I'm a kook. I get so much out of life, really I do, scooba-dee-boo. One more time, play Mac the Knife. Let her rip, I mean flip. But I'm hip, oh, tell the world I'm hip. Yes, well, don't you know that I'm hip? Well, now, dig on me. Well, can't you see that I'm hip? Oh, yes, I'm hip. Better show this to Quincy. Oh, yes. You better believe I'm hip. I'm
hi, I'm Bob Clone.
And I'm Bob Clone.
And I'm Bob Clone.
And I'm Bob Clone.
And we're owners and operators of Clone Brothers Discount Art Mart, where we can sell you authentic reproductions of famous works of art at less than it would cost if you painted them yourself. Think of your living room, den, or other area beautified by what we call Mona Lisa. It's so real, your guests will think it's real. We have works by nearly every artist known, dead, alive, and some not even born yet.
Matisse,
Piccolo,
Von Gogh,
Norman Rockwell, yes?
We have hundreds of each in our gigantic Art Mart warehouse, unmatted, framed, matted, or slightly crushed, and they're all super discounted for your convenience and savings. Turn your drab home into a museum today. Call or write the number listed on the bottom of your radio.
Come as you like and come as you are, come quickly as soon as you can. Come in a motorboat, come in a car, and come to the magic toy land. The party's never been a dud, especially if you're a spud. Today's the day, Mr. Potato Head's picnic.
Picnic time for Potato Head. Mr. Potato Head is having a wonderful time today. Watch them dance until they're dead. Potato Head, have all come out to play. Before your eyes, their heads will sprout. Pull their eyeballs out before they go back to bed. At 6 o'clock your mommy will mash them and serve them up with steak, because they're tired little potato heads.
them, walk them, leap them, crawl. They want to attack the three Barbie dolly pops out of the cake at Mr. Potato Head's picnic. Pick a nick of time for a potato head. Mr. Potato Head is having a wonderful time today. Watch them dance them till they're dead. Potato heads have all come out to play. Before your eyes and heads will sprout, they'll pull their eyeballs out before they go back to bed. At 6 o'clock, your mommy will mash them and serve them up with steak because they're tired little potato heads.
That's Picnic Time for Potato Heads, Dementia from the great state of New Mexico, featuring Stephen M. Terrell on the Dr. Demento Show. And we started out that little set with Dave Frischberg and I'm Hip. And then we heard from the Clone Brothers, created in his own image by Jeff Brown of Bellingham, Washington.
Why did Danny the drummer stop chewing carefree and start chewing new and improved Chewels?
Chewels tastes better.
Why did the Chatham cheerleader stop?
Chewels taste better!
Why did Doug the dog trainer stop?
Chewels taste better!
New and improved Chewels is the only sugarless gum with a delicious flavor center and test proof of leading sugarless gums.
Chewels taste better!
Now and then, Dimensions and Dementites, even the very best radio stations, get complaints from disgruntled members of the listening audience. We'll hear an extreme case of that next on the Dr. Demento Show.
Dr. Demento.
Now, let's see. Let's get a little music in here. What do we get here?
Sex and drugs and rock and roll.
Uh-oh, new wave strikes again.
Is all my brain and body need.
What a song, jeez.
Sex and drugs and rock and roll.
What? Don't play rock and roll music. It's dirty and suggestive. What if little kids are listening to it?
I give up. What if little kids are listening to it?
Well, they might get the idea that they're supposed to go out and have sex and listen to rock and roll music and take drugs. It would just be awful.
Okay. Look, I'll find something else, okay? Let's see. Okay, nobody can get offended by country western, right?
Hey, hurting me now don't mean a thing.
Except maybe a Led Zeppelin fan or something like that, I don't know.
Since love ain't here, don't feel pain. My mind ain't nothing but a total blank. I think I'll just stay here and drain.
You can't play country western!
Wait a second, what's wrong with country western? I mean, mom, apple pie, the American flag, driving trucks?
But studies have proven that when they play country western music in bars, people drink more! And if people get drunk, they might drive and hurt somebody!
Okay. Let's see. What do we got here? Oh, no. Not that I mind, but why no disco?
Why no disco? Don't you know that's devil music?
What?
Why, don't you know disco has a syncopated rhythm that makes people want to have sex, and you know how dirty that is?
I don't know. All it's ever made me want to do is throw up.
Now, don't give me any of that. Now, you have a moral obligation as a guardian of the public trust to play music that's appropriate for moral people to listen to.
Okay. Stop whining. I'll find something. Okay, a little triple Z jazz never hurt anybody. A little Chuck Mangione, flugelhorn here and there.
Don't play triple Z jazz!
Okay, I'm listening. Why?
Because triple Z jazz is popular with high-income drug users, and if you play that, you're just gonna make them happier. What do you want to say? You make your living playing music for marijuana addicts or something?
Okay! Oh, jeez. You know, sometimes Mozart can be very soothing.
Don't play classical music!
All right, this is the last straw. What's wrong with classical music?
Because lots of scientists listen to classical music, and if scientists like classical music and they listen to it, they'll be happy. And if they're happy, they'll be able to get more work done. And if they get more work done, there'll be all sorts of terrible things to make our life miserable. Why, we might even have nuclear power, and we'll have a meltdown, and we might all melt down or something like that. I couldn't use my vibrator.
Shut up!
An extreme case? Well, maybe not. That was put together by Deloy Parks, who is a disc jockey in Kennewick, Washington. I think he knows whereof he speaks. We all run into people like that in the radio biz. Deloy Parks calls that one Moral Majority Top 40. An extreme case? Well, not the first of its type. Here's one by Stan Freeberg, recorded in 1957.
Well, it's great to be with you tonight. We have a...
Pardon me, Mr. Freeberg, but my name is Tweedley.
Well, we all have our problems.
I am the censor from the Citizens Radio Committee, and I feel...
You, from the Citizens Radio Committee, you say?
It's exactly what I said, yes.
Mm-hmm. And what is your purpose in being here?
I must okay all the material used on your program here, and I think the best method is to just sit back here and interrupt when I feel it's necessary.
You mean you plan to stop me every time I do something that you think is wrong?
Exactly. I'll just sound my little horn like this. And then you stop, and I'll tell you what's wrong.
Somehow I can tell this is going to be one of those days.
You just go right ahead, Mr. Freeberg. Don't mind me.
Yeah, now I'd like to say...
You forgot to say thank you, Mr. Freeberg. Politeness is an essential in radio programming. Your program goes into the home. We must be a good influence on children.
And that's a darling little horn there. Mm-hmm. Thanks very much, Mr. Tweedley.
You're welcome, I'm sure.
I'd like to sing a old river song in honor this week of National Mississippi Riverboat Paddle Wheel Week. Mr. May, if you please.
Very polite, Mr. Freeberg.
Thank you.
Old Man River, that old...
All right, Tweedley, politeness I dig, but what in the world is wrong with Old Man River?
The word old has a connotation some of the more elderly people find distasteful. I would suggest you make the substitution, please.
I suppose you insist?
Precisely. You may continue.
Okay, music.
You forgot to say thank you.
Say thank you, yes, okay. Thank you, Mr. Tweedley.
You're quite welcome, I am sure.
Elderly man river, that elderly man river, he must know something, but he don't say nothing.
All right, hold it, fellas. Now what, Tweedley?
The word something, you left off the G.
But that's authentic. Something, something. That's the way the people talk down there.
What? The home is a classroom, Mr. Freeberg.
I know you said that.
Keep in mind the tiny tots. And furthermore, think back. You'll recall that you said, but he don't say nothing.
Mm-hmm.
Now, really, Mr. Freeberg, that's a double negative. Do you mean he does say something?
No, I just wasn't using my head, I guess.
I mean, after all, it should be grammatically correct, keeping in mind...
And the tiny tot, yes.
You probably mean he doesn't say anything.
I suppose I mean that, yes, I guess. All right, fine. You win. All right, Billy, music. Thank you. Thank you.
You're welcome, I'm sure.
Elderly man river, that elderly man river, he must know something, but he doesn't say anything. He just keeps rolling, rolling. He just keeps rolling along. Doesn't plant taters, potatoes. He doesn't plant cotton, cotting. And them, these, those that plants them are soon forgotting. But elderly man river, he just keeps rolling along.
Excellent.
Thank you. The tiny tots again, was it?
Exactly.
Sorry about that. Here we go.
You and I, we sweat, perspire, and strain. Bodies awakened and racked with pain.
Oh, we got by that one. take your finger off the button, Mr. Tweedley. We know when we're licked. Well, that concludes Elderly Man River. Oh, yes, and thank you for being with us, Mr. Tweedley.
You're welcome, I'm sure.
Wow, I'm so bored. There's nothing to do. God. Today I went to the supermarket. They were playing this music. I was so bored. I just stood there and listened to it and read all the labels on the frozen TV dinners. It was so boring. I walked outside and I saw this movie theater. So I went in. They were playing this stupid French movie. You know the kind. You have to read all those little words at the bottom of the screen. And they make those jokes. They're not even funny. This guy came and sat down next to me. There was bubblegum on his seat, his leisure suit that stuck to the chair. I would have laughed if I wasn't so bored. Kept trying to talk to me. Wanted to go to a motel or something. I said yes, just to shut him up. And all the way there, he kept talking about his wife. It was so boring. We got there. First he put on this weird rubber costume. And then he had me handcuffed into the bed. He looked so stupid lying there. I got bored, so I turned around and left. As I shut the door, I heard him screaming for me to come back to let him loose. But I was so bored, I figured, what's the point? Then I had to take the bus home. God, all the way home, the bus driver kept dropping his transfer so he could bend over and look at my dress. Buses are so boring. So here I am, home again. Nothing ever happens. I think I'll go to the refrigerator and get a towel. Then I'll just go to sleep. God, I'm so bored.
So bored. Jane Bond and the Undercover Men on the Dr. Demento Show. Well, you might think that the emotions expressed in that song, or the lack of them, are so typical of the 1980s, but actually, I have a record here from 1952 that expresses very much the same sentiments, though in the musical style and using the cultural references of the early 50s. This was the song that first made Eartha Kitt famous, and it's called Monotonous.
Into a dull routine. If they don't get a chance to change the scene, I could not be wearier. Life could not be drearier if I lived in Siberia. I'll tell ya what I mean. I met a rather amusing fool while on my way to Istanbul. He bought me the Black Sea for my swimming pool. Monotonous for 30 days. Salt air I sniffed while I was shipwrecked and cast adrift with a man who looked like Montgomery Clift. Monotonous for what it's worth. Throughout the earth, I'm known as Femme Fatale. But when the yawn comes up like thunder, brother, take back your Taj Mahal. Jack Fath made a new style for me. I even made Johnny Ray smile for me. A camel once walked a mile for me. Monotonous. Monotonous. I could not be wearier. Life could not be drearier if I lived in Siberia. Traffic has been known to stop for me. Prices even rise and drop for me. Harry S. Truman plays bop for me. Monotonous. monotonous. T.S. Eliot writes books for me. King Farouk's on tender hooks for me. Sherman Billingsley even cooks for me. Monotonous. Monotonous. I could not be real. Life could not be dreary if I lived in Siberia. Although I know I've acres of dough, I'm not sure of the amount. It might be exciting someday if I learn to count. Chiang Kai-shek sends me pots of tea. Gaylord Houser sends me vitamin D. And furthermore, Ike likes me. Monotonous. Monotonous. Monotonous.
From the legendary Broadway show called New Faces of 1952, 30 years old this year, and you can still buy the album, Eartha Kitt and Monotonous, on the Dr. Demento Show.
Betcha I can put a watermelon in my mouth.
That's impossible.
A delicious has a brand new flavor.
Lay out watermelon.
The
Bubblicious bubblegum. Soft, juicy.
And big bubbles like Bubblicious strawberry, orange, and banana.
Mmm, delicious. You really can put a watermelon in your mouth.
Not so impossible.
The ultimate bubble has the ultimate flavors. Bubblicious.
The party goes on here in Dementia. Next, we'll have the tale of Barnacle Bill the Sailor. This one's for Jim Denson of Philadelphia. Truly an all-star session led by the late Hoagy Carmichael. Features Bix Beiderbecke on cornet, Benny Goodman on clarinet, Gene Krupa on drums, Joe Venuti on violin and a very curious bass vocal, and Carson Robison, who wrote the song on lead vocal. Here's Barnacle Bill the Sailor.
From over the sea.
Barnacle Bill the Sailor.
I'm all lit up like a Christmas tree.
Barnacle Bill the Sailor.
I'll sail the seas until I croak. I'll fight and swear and drink and smoke, but I can't swim a bloody stroke.
Said Barnacle Bill the Sailor.
Your wine and eat your pies. I'll kiss your cheeks and black your eyes.
Barnacle Bill the Sailor.
one little piece of sugar.
Be done, 6 foot six with flippers on. He's the biggest, baddest diver we've ever done. Now every morning by the beach you could see him arrive. He was 6 foot six, the biggest diver alive. Yellow teeth, armpits that stank, biceps as big as scuba tanks, Big Don. Don had a spear gun 10 feet long with 14 rubbers and a triple prong. Power head strapped to his side, and from his spear many fish have died, Big Don. Now Don, he shot everything in sight, and if he couldn't get to it, he'd use dynamite. Killing little fish made him feel tough, till one day the critters thought they had enough of Don. So they had him a meeting, they had him a talk, underneath a blasted coral rock. That menace diver, he had to die. It was up to them to give it a try to get Don. So they sent him a message out across the sea to a long great white they call Sharky. Sharky lived off the Australian shore. His teeth, they numbered 2,000 or more. They were for Don. Now when Sharky heard about Dirty Don, he put his best row of choppers on and through the sea cut a giant fin. A great white shark was out to get him, Big Don. Big Don, Big Don, 6 foot six with flippers on. He's the biggest, baddest diver, Big Bad Don. So that giant fish waited through the night, waited till the moment was right, until Big Don would be in sight. He'd finish him up with just one bite, Big Don. Soon the sun rose in the east, and there was Don, and there was the beast. Don had a feeling in his bones, something was wrong, he wasn't alone, Big Don. As he turned around with a kick of a fin, there was Sharky heading right for him. So he raised his gun, he took an aim, but all his efforts were in vain, Big Don. The spear bounced off Sharky like a rubber ball. He didn't budge and he didn't stall. An instant later, the sea was red, and everybody knew that he was dead, Big Don. Now there wasn't too much left of Don, except maybe his spear with a triple prong. Not a fish of the sea have even to score, and Sharky weighs 200 pounds more, because inside of his belly lies Big Bad Don. Big Don, 6 foot six with flippers on. He's the biggest, baddest diver, Big Bad Don.
From the Grand Cayman Islands, Scuba Diver's Paradise, the Barefoot Man and Big Bad Diver Don from his new album of scuba songs called Scooba-Doo 2. And before that, Hoagie Carmichael on the Dr. Demento Show and his band with Barnacle Bill the Sailor.
Why did Roger the Riveter stop chewing carefree and start chewing new and improved Chewels?
Chewels taste better.
Why did Terry the Tap Dancer stop?
Chewels tastes better.
Why did Paul the piano player stop?
Chewels tastes better.
New and improved Chewels is the only sugarless gum with a delicious flavor center. And test proof of leading sugarless gums.
Chewels tastes better.
We'll go from Cheech and Chong to Chuck Berry in the next set on the Dr. Demento Show and also indulge in a little tomfoolery.
Dr. Demento!
Hi, Dr. Demento. This is Richard Adkins, Bremerton, Washington. And Dr. Demento, my request is the rubber ducky. Yes!
Well, here I am in my tubby again, and my tubby's all filled with water and nice fluffy suds. And I've got my soap and washcloth to wash myself, and I've got my nifty scrub brush to help me scrub my back, and I've got a big fluffy towel to dry myself when I'm done. But there's one other thing that makes tubby time the very best time of the whole day. And do you know what that is? It's a very special friend of mine, my very favorite little pal. Oh, rubber ducky, you're the one. You make bath time lots of fun. Rubber ducky, I'm awfully fond of you. Bo-vo-bo-dee-o, rubber ducky, joy of joys. When I squeeze you, you make noise. Rubber ducky, you're my very best friend, it's true. Oh, every day when I make my way to the tubby, I find a little fella who's cute and yellow and shabby. Rub-a-dub-dubby, rubber ducky, you're so fine, and I'm lucky that you're mine. Rubber ducky, I'm awfully fond of you. Hey, rubber ducky, would you like me to scrub your back with my nifty little scrub brush? You would? Okay, how's this? Hey, you want me to scrub behind your ears? Ooh, I see. You don't have any ears, do you? Well, how about your tummy? Scrub his little ducky tummy. Ooh, he's ticklish. Oh, every day when I make my way to the tubby, I find a little fella who's cute and yellow and chubby. Rub-a-dub-dubby, rub-a-ducky, you're so fine, and I'm lucky that you're mine. Rubber ducky, I'd like a whole pond of. Rubber ducky, I'm awfully fond of you.
Well, it's what Jim Henson used to do before Miss Piggy made him a millionaire. Jim Henson singing Rubber Ducky from the very first Sesame Street album on the Dr. Demento Show.
Attention, Earthlings! Stay tuned to this transmission for information on obtaining Dr. Demento T-shirt. Stay tuned. Stay tuned.
Don't you dare touch that dial or we'll have Chuck Berry ring his ding-a-ling on you.
We got to do our alma mater. We must do our alma mater. When I was a little bitty boy, my grandmother bought me a cute little toy. Silver bells hanging on a string. She told me it was my ding-a-ling-a-ling.
And then Mama took me to grammar school, but I stopped off in the vestibule. Every time that bell would ring, catch me playing with my ding-a-ling-a-ling. Oh,
ding-a-ling, ding-a-ling.
Is beautiful. You know what I heard? I hear two girls over here singing in harmony. That's all right, honey. This is a free country. Live like you want to live, baby. Yeah. Ain't nobody gonna knock it, darling. Mm-mm. Yeah, freedom. Yes, sir. There's one guy right over here singing mine, too. That's all right, brother. Yes, sir. You got a right, baby. Ain't nobody gonna bother you. Yeah. Once I was climbing the garden wall, I slipped and had a terrible fall. I fell so hard I heard bells ring, but held on to my ding-a-ling. Your parliament out there singing. Oh yeah. Once I was swimming across Turtle Creek, man, them snappers all around my feet. Sure was hard swimming across that thing with both hands holding my
finger.
Oh. Beautiful. I think it's a beautiful little song. Really, I do. And guess what? Everybody's still not singing. There's a few right down front here that's not singing. We're going to dedicate this verse to those who will not sing. Yes, sir. This here song, it ain't so sad. The cutest little song you ever had. Those of you who will not sing, you must be playing with your own.
everybody's mind. Oh, my. Slow down. I wanna play everybody with my jingle.
Hello, doctor.
Oh, hello. How you doing?
Is this the acupuncture clinic?
Oh, yeah. I'm a Dr. Long Wong.
Oh,
Dr.
yeah.
Dr. Wong, acupuncture clinic.
Yeah. Well, I have this headache, doctor, and I just can't get rid of it, man. I've tried everything. I tried the hypnosis and yoga. I stood on my head and I tried Quaaludes and Coke, and nothing will get rid of it, man. I'm a nervous wreck. I haven't slept for 3 days, and I'm really in a lot of pain. Could you help me?
You have a headache.
Yeah, oh, yeah.
A headache, a pain in the head.
Mm-hmm.
When the people talk loud around you.
Yeah,
you,
yeah, when they talk
hurt
loud.
Hurt a head.
Oh, yeah.
And when the noise of people every day come
yeah.
by, say hello,
uh-huh.
everything, you hurt in the head.
Yeah, uh-huh.
It'll make a headache.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, you come to the right place.
Oh.
Acupuncture can cure everything.
Yeah, I've heard that. That's my girlfriend's
head. Acupuncture in China. It cure everything.
Yeah.
In China, a pregnant lady,
uh-huh.
come
yeah.
and we give acupuncture, and they have a baby with no pain.
Oh, yeah,
no
that's
pain.
Great.
Next
great.
Day, they're yeah. in the field, they work in yeah. the field.
Uh-huh.
Acupuncture can fix a headache,
mm-hmm.
Fix a backache,
mm-hmm. yeah,
fix
well,
anything.
Just a headache.
You got a headache.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, my God.
Now, you have acupuncture before.
No, never did.
You know have acupuncture before.
Oh, no. Uh-huh.
Well, that's why you have headache. If
yeah.
you have acupuncture before, you have no headache.
Oh, yeah.
No headache.
Uh-huh, uh-huh.
But acupuncture, okay. Get up on the table here.
Okay.
Up on the table.
Okay.
Now, you never have this before.
No.
Okay, we better stop you in the first time.
What?
Well, just so you won't make a wrong move and kill yourself.
What?
Just a little joke. No, I don't want you to interfere with my hand when I move a needle. You
okay.
might... don't make
yeah,
a
yeah,
mess.
Yeah, okay.
You understand?
Whatever you say.
Oh, okay, now stop in the arm.
Uh-huh.
I stop in your arm. I stop in... Now, maybe you better take off your shoes.
Huh? Okay.
No, just a minute. No, you leave a shoe on.
Oh.
Phew.
God. If you could just help me, I haven't slept in over a week.
Man, like you haven't washed for over a week.
Yeah,
okay. Anyway, no matter.
Oh.
We stop with your leg down.
Yeah,
we stop with your arm down.
Uh-huh.
Okay, now you see. Do you want to have nothing to be scared? No frightening. I show you the needle.
Okay.
See the needle?
Okay, that's a long needle.
Well, it has to be long. It has to be long. It goes through your skull and into the spine.
What?
See.
What?
No, I just a joke.
Oh.
Just a little joke to relieve a tension.
Yeah, okay.
A lot of tension with
yeah,
the headache.
A lot of tension, Doc.
Okay. Now, I take the needle. Now, when I put a needle, you watch, I put a needle with no nerve so you don't feel no pain. You see, I'm going to put the needle right there,
oh.
and I turn it with
oh.
my finger,
wait, oh.
and you don't feel nothing.
Mm.
It don't hurt. Mm. You don't feel nothing, do you?
It hurts,
though. Okay. Now, we have another needle.
Mm.
I want to stick over here. No nerve. You don't feel nothing.
Mm. Oh, wait.
There you go.
Oh, that hurts.
There you go.
Oh,
pretty soon,
wait a minute.
You feel really good.
Don't twist it, man. That
really
hurts.
Really good.
Oh. That hurts.
Go. Now we have another needle.
Another one.
Now, you heard a yin yang.
Yeah.
Yin yang?
Uh-huh.
Okay, this needle, we're going to stick in your yin yang.
What?
There
we go. Wait, we'll take it out. Take
okay, that's the best part.
Oh, take it out. That hurts.
There we go. Now, I want you to watch closely, because when you got needles sticking in like this here, listen, you can play a tune.
Ding, ding, ding.
Is that how you make a Chinese music?
Take them out.
Now, before I take out the needle, how you want to pay?
What?
It costs $150 for first treatment.
I don't have $150.
You don't have $150.
No, take them out. Oh, please take them out.
Oh, I can't take them out with no money. You see, they go in free, but I cost the money to take out.
Oh, please take them out.
Oh, I know. Oh. I have one more needle.
No.
One more. This to help you pay.
No.
This one go underneath your fingernail.
No.
Very effective in Japan.
No. Oh, I'll pay. I won't take it. Get my wallet.
got massive charges.
Okay.
Oh, God. Oh, take him out. Take him out.
There
oh,
we go. Okay. Where's your wallet? Okay, I got a... You take a massive... We take a massive charge.
Yeah,
is that your family?
Take him out.
Cute kid.
Cute.
Yes, Carol.
But much more for the touch of your whips, yeah. You could raise whelps like nobody else as we danced the masochism tango. There's our lobby of flame, not an ember. Say it's me that you want to dismember. Blacken my eye, set fire to my tie as we danced the masochism tango. At your command, before you here I stand. My heart is in my hand. Tis here that I must be. My heart entreats. Just hear those savage beats. And go put on your cleats and come and trample me. Your heart's hard as stone or mahogany. That's why I am in such exquisite agony. My soul is on fire. It's aflame with desire. Which is why I perspire when I tango. You caught my nose in your left castanet. I can never forget. Love, how this passion was born. How I envied the rose that your teeth used to clench. Love, when I tried something French. Love, all I got was a thorn. Sew up the gash that you made with your lash. As we danced the masochism tango. Bash in my brain and make me scream with pain. And kiss me once again and say we'll never part. I know full well I'm underneath your spell. So darling, if you smell something burning, it's my heart. Take your cigarette from its holder. Burn your initials on my shoulder. Scratch my spine and say you'll be mine. As we dance to the masso. Tism tango.
With lyrics specially revised by the composer Tom Lehrer. That's from the London cast album of Tom Foolery, the Masochism Tango. On the Dr. Demento Show, we had Cheech and Chong with Acupuncture from their Let's Make a New Dope Deal album, and Chuck Berry with his all-timer My Ding-a-ling.
Betcha I can put a watermelon in my mouth.
That's impossible.
Delicious has a brand new flavor.
Way out watermelon.
The ultimate
watermelon Bubblicious bubblegum. Soft, juicy.
And big bubbles like Bubblicious strawberry, orange, and banana.
Mmm, delicious. You really can't put a watermelon in your mouth.
Not so impossible.
The ultimate bubble has the ultimate flavors.
Oh. Got something delicious for you next on the Dr. Demento Show. Mm-hmm.
Dr. Demento.
Ooh, we're gonna have fun.
Yes.
It's a cozy table, isn't it?
And champagne, my dear.
Hmm. delicious.
You like it? Me.
delicious.
I like it too. Yes, I do like it.
delicious.
Yes, it is. You want some more?
Delicious.
I knew you'd like it. You always.
Delicious.
Oh, have some more. Get the waiter and hombre. Delicious. Oh, I'll put on the paper hat. Oh, get out the lamp. I even like the cork. Waiter, waiter, more. Oh, keep pouring. Oh, this is oh, every night, New Year's Eve. You got it, every night we're going to do this. I don't care. Lose the job every day. What are you going to do?
Okay, where are you? I'm over here, eh?
No.
Okay, like, here we are at Peter's Donut.
Oh, take off. We are not.
Three. We are.
What?
Thanks.
Okay.
Thanks.
No,
thanks for blowing it.
No, you're right. It's 3.
Oh, no, no.
No, it's 3 in the morning and we're at, what? Whose donuts?
Peter's
Donut. Oh, Peter's Donut.
There, she's at the till now. She'll see us in a minute, eh? You want your favorite donut?
Hey, over here.
I'm going to get him booted out.
Oh, good going.
Hey, over here for donuts.
Don't listen to him, eh? He's a hoser.
What kind of donut you order?
A cruller.
No, I want a pineapple filled. Yeah. I like raised chocolate in the evening and pineapple overnight.
Okay, one pineapple-filled donut.
Thanks.
And a six-pack of Crillers.
A six?
Yeah, for me, eh? I didn't have any dinner.
And you're not going to have any breakfast either.
Oh, and two coffees, yeah. I'll make his black, and mine's triple sugar and triple cream.
Boy, go to the dentist. Okay, I have a topic.
Okay.
While we're waiting.
Go.
Okay, you know, okay, in the Great White North, it went metric, right?
Yeah.
Before anywhere else in the world, right?
Yeah.
So, like, a lot of people don't know how to figure out metric, right? Okay, so...
Me neither.
Okay, I'll teach it. So, okay. There's a fast way, which is to double it and add 30, okay? So, like, if it's, let's say, on the radio, it says, okay, so today it'll be cloudy and 5 degrees. So, how do you do it? You go, you double it, 5 is 10, you add 30. 30
yeah.
And 10 is 40. It's the old 40 degrees. So, when you say 5 degrees, 40.
Like, how many... beers would that be if you want like a six pack in metric?
12 and 30 is 42 beers. 42 metric beers.
Well, that's good for me, eh?
Yeah.
I count me in on metric.
Yeah, and back bacon is like normally you eat a pound, right?
Yeah.
So in metric, you double it as 2 and 30 is 32 kilos of back bacon.
Yeah, but what if the speed limit is like 50 miles an hour? Eh?
Yeah.
Then what do you do? Double it, 100 and add 30?
Yeah.
So you can go 130 miles an
hour? No, not miles. 130 kilometers an hour.
Would you get a ticket if you were going that fast?
No.
Well, that's good, because we're getting one now. Look.
Jesus. Donut places. The guy's got 10 tables in 3 spots.
Yeah, well, it was your idea to park on the street, Jose.
Take off. You drove. Let's go.
You go. You go talk to the guy.
Give the cops donuts, and they won't give a ticket.
Hey, cops, want donuts?
You pay for the donuts. I'll go talk to the cops.
All cops listen to this album. Don't give us tickets.
Yeah, at least not at a donut place, eh?
Come on, let's get out of here.
We'll give you donuts if you don't give us a ticket.
Yeah, we'll mail them to you.
Jeez, again.
Let's get out of here.
Donut place. They never have...
Bob and Doug McKenzie. They'll be our guests next week under the smogberry trees, bringing a little bit of that great white north down here. Peter's Donuts from their new album, and we had Jim Backus and Friend with Delicious on the Dr. Demento Show. Hey, time to give us a phone call. Actually, you can call us anytime, but why not do it now while the rates are low? If we use your voice on the radio, you win a Dr. Demento t-shirt of your very own. Here's our number once again. Please dial carefully. Area code 213-652-8028. That's 213-652-8028. Back in the early days of radio, one of the most entertaining things they had on the air was the amateur hours, where people from all walks of life would get up and perform. Well, we've kind of lost that spirit in this over-professionalized age, but I'm going to bring it back right now and play a cassette that was given to me by a young fellow by the name of Fred Warren. And this is a wonderful song called Who Committed Mutiny.
Now, who committed mutiny down on the farm? Who put the cow?
Busybody, though I know it's very shoddy. I insist on knowing what is going on with everybody, cause I'm such a busybody, always frying, always buying. I'm defying anyone to try to hide the fact from me. Now Mrs. Jones is with the doctor, and her pulse is finally clocked, and suddenly she sees me peeking into all her friends. I'm shrieking, Mrs. Jones's valve is leaking, a mechanic she is seeking, cause her clutch needs overhauling, and her motor's always stalling. Mrs. Jones, you lonesome gal, you finally lost your trade in value. Now we come to Mr. Clunky, thinks that I'm a little funky. He's always keeping up with Jones, and while I tap his telephone, I learn that they will disconnect him soon. The bill they don't collect, the sheriff's gonna take it back, his brand new shiny Cadillac. So now I pass the news around that Mr. Clunk is bankrupt bound. I'm ruining his credit, and I know he won't forget it, though he thought I was a little punk, a cabbage headed Mr. Clunk. I got the bank to fume and fret. They took his home, and better yet, they grabbed his television set, because I'm such a busybody. I'm a little busybody. If you drink an extra toddy, I will spot it long before you spot it. I'll be pointing to your house and telling folks that you're a south. Though I admit I am a louse, it's so much fun to tell the neighbors that you're underneath the weather, and they ought to get together, using you as an example to their kids of what a tramp will do if he is off the wagon. Now your reputation's dragging, cause you took an extra toddy, and I'm telling everybody that you're more than slightly dizzy. Now I've got you in the tizzy, cause I'm such a very busy little busybody. I'm the death of every party. You should hear the things I say when truth and consequence replay. I state the age of Mrs. Dunn. I tell him she is 61 and that her face is lifted and her cargo slightly shifted. There are couples kissing in the dark. I use my flashlight for a lark, and Joan is hugging Mortimer, and she's engaged to Mr. Shore. I'm hiding in the cusped door and flash a light upon their face while they are locked in fond embrace, and Mr. Shore then wrecks the place. I'm such a busybody, breaking up a lovely party. Mabel Smith is on the scale, and suddenly she's growing pale, for in a chorus so endearing, I have got the neighbors cheering. Darling, what a lovely weight. You weigh 188. You lick the pattern off the plate, and then you bleed for more to eat. You look just like a strange balloon that drifted to us from the moon, and scientists must watch their step and see if you're a secret weapon. That is how the gossip goes, and all because I stick my nose in other people's dirty clothes. A heavy-winded diam, I don't need a breath to say goodbye, because I'm such a busy little busybody. Busy booty bee.
Jerry Lewis on the Dr. Demento Show with I'm a Little Busybody. I think he was the one who committed that mutiny there. Fred Warren sang, Who Committed Mutiny?
Why did Danny the drummer stop chewing carefree and start chewing new and improved Chewels?
Chewels tastes better.
Rah, 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 rah,
why did the Chatham cheerleader stop?
Chewels tastes better.
Why did Doug the dog trainer stop?
Chewels taste better.
New and improved Chewels is the only sugarless gum with a delicious flavor center and test proof of leading sugarless gums.
Chewels taste better!
All right, Dimensions and Dementites, be forewarned. We are about to approach the climax of the show. It's almost funny five time. All right, Dimensions and Dementites, what time is it now?
It's funny five time.
Demented discs of the week, and here in number five position, I proudly bring you the tunes.
Push a razor blade into your nose, whip your partner with a rubber hose, spit at the band, cause that's the way it goes. Do the punk polka. Drink a little beer and drink a little scotch. Turn around and kick your neighbor in the crotch. It's no fun if you just sit and watch. Do the punk polka.
Jump, 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 up and down and play. Grab a safety pin into your face. Excuse me while I leave the human race. Just do the fun, polka.
Nothing but death, nothing but death. Nothing but death and destruction. Bad breath, armpits, terminal acne. Nothing but death for me.
From the San Francisco Bay Area via the album Dr. Demento's Dementia Royale come the tunes with song number five on our Funny Five this week, the Punk Polka. The perpetrator of our number four song this week is no stranger to the charts. He wrote a book that reached number one on the nonfiction sales charts, a book called A Light in the Attic, Whimsical Poems and Drawings by Shel Silverstein. From one of his earlier books, Where the Sidewalk Ends, comes this little song.
Oh, Sarah Cynthia Sylvia Stout would not take the garbage out. She'd wash the dishes and scrub the pans, cook the yams and spice the hams, and though her parents would scream and shout, she simply would not take the garbage out. And so it piled up to the ceilings, coffee grounds, potato peelings, brown bananas and rotten peas, chunks of sour cottage cheese. It filled the can, it covered the floor, it cracked the windows and blocked the door with bacon rinds and chicken bones, drippy ends of ice cream cones, prune pits, peach pits, orange peel, gloppy glumps of cold oatmeal, pizza crust.
crust and withered greens, soggy beans and tangerines, crusts of blackburn buttered toast, gristly bits of beefy roast. The garbage rolled on down the hall. It raised the roof. It broke the walls. I mean, greasy napkins, cookie crumbs, blobs of gooey bubble gum, cellophane from old bologna, rubbery, blubbery macaroni, peanut butter cake and dry curdled milk and crust of pie, rotting melon, slide up mustard, eggshells mixed with lemon custard, cold french fries and rancid meat, yellow lumps of cream of wheat. At last, the garbage reached so high that finally it touched the sky, and none of her friends would come to play, and all the neighbors moved away, and finally Sarah Cynthia Stout said, "Okay, I'll take the garbage out." But then, of course, it was too late. The garbage reached across the state from New York to the Golden Gate. And there, in the garbage, she did hate. Poor Sarah met an awful fate that I cannot right now relate, because the hour is much too late. But children, remember Sarah Stout, and always take the garbage out.
From the album Freakin' at the Freaker's Ball, Shel Silverstein, Uncle Shelby. Singing and playing his own composition, Sarah Cynthia Sylvia Stout would not take the garbage out. Number 4 on the Dr. Demento Funny 5.
Betcha I can put a watermelon in my mouth.
That's impossible.
All delicious
has a brand new flavor. Lay out watermelon.
The ultimate marvel has the ultimate flavor.
Watermelon Bubblicious Bubblegum. Soft, juicy.
And big bubbles like Bubblicious Strawberry, Orange, and Banana.
Mmm, delicious. You really can put a watermelon in your mouth.
Not so impossible.
The ultimate bubble has the ultimate flavor. Oh. Bubblicious.
2 down, 3 to go on the Dr. Demento Funny 5.
Norquist calling from Fargo, North Dakota, and I would hit it all time, the minute favorite, the coming gun. You gotta take me away!
Remember when you ran away and I got on my knees and begged you not to leave because I go berserk? Well, you left me anyhow, and then the days got worse and worse, and now you see I've gone completely out of my mind. And they're coming to take me away, ha-ha, they're coming to take me away, ho-ho, hee-hee, ha-ha, to the funny farm where life is beautiful all the time, and I'll be happy to see those nice young men in their clean white coats, and they're coming to take me away, ha-ha! You thought it was a joke, and so you laughed when I had said that losing you would make me flip my lid, right? You know you laughed. I heard you laugh. You laughed, you laughed, and laughed, and then you left. But now you know I'm utterly mad. And they're coming to take me away, ha-ha. They're coming to take me away, ho-ho, hee-hee, ha-ha. To the happy home with trees and flowers and chirping birds and basket weavers who sit and smile and twiddle their thumbs and toes, and they're coming to take me away, I cooked your food, I cleaned your house, and this is how you pay me back for all my kind, unselfish, loving deeds. Huh? Well, you just wait, they'll find you yet, and when they do, they'll put you in the ASPCA, you mangy mutt. And they're coming to take me away, ha-ha, they're coming to take me away, ho-ho, hee-hee, ha-ha, to the funny farm where life is beautiful all the time, and I'll be happy to see those nice young men in their clean white coats, and they're coming to take me away, ha-ha, to the happy home with trees and flowers and chirping birds and basket weavers who sit and smile and twiddle their thumbs and toes, and they're coming to take me away, ha-ha, to the funny farm.
Napoleon the 14th from the Dr. Demento's Delights album, They're Coming to Take Me Away, ha-ha! Number 3 on the Funny 5.
Hey, what the hell kind of deal is that?
Greetings, Earthlings. We are from the galaxy of Earthquacks, and in a healthy planet in search of food, water, and teachers.
No kidding.
We would not drive you, Earthlings. We have found what is believed to be the best teacher deal this side of the M96 star cluster.
What kind of deal is that?
It is a full-color Dr. Demento
a minute. Let me write that down, okay?
Repeat. Van $5.95 plus $1 for postage and handling to Dr. Demento, P.O. Box 884, Silver City, California, 90230. And do not forget to take your body coordinates.
My what?
Your t-shirt size.
Okay. Sounds like a pretty good deal to me.
To be sure. Well, gotta go. It has been a pleasure conversing with you. And don't forget to remain demented.
Put on one of those babies and you'll be ready to take off. Here's number two on the funny five.
Huh? Okay, now be real nice to him, eh?
Okay.
Okay. This is the hit single section of our album. Good day. Good day. Geddy Lee is here from Rush. Hi, Geddy. I'm Bob McKenzie. This is my brother Doug. How's it going, Geddy?
Oh, it's going pretty good. Good day, eh?
Good day. Good day. Thanks for coming down to do our hit.
Well, my pleasure, eh?
Did our lawyer call you?
Yeah, $10 is $10.
I hope you don't mind, but there's a photographer that's going to be taking pictures of us together to prove that you were here doing the record.
In case people don't believe us.
Yeah.
How come he's not wearing a toque?
Oh, he's not from the Great White North. Yeah.
Okay, so if you'd like to put on a toque and some headphones, we can do the hit single now.
Sure.
Okay.
That'd be great.
Do you have the lyric sheet?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
I memorized them.
Oh, great. Beauty.
Okay. How did you do that so fast?
I'm a professional, eh?
Oh.
We'll just sit over here, like, while you're singing, eh?
Okay.
Okay.
All right.
Okay. Thanks, guys.
Okay. Good luck, eh?
Good luck.
Okay. This is where the DJ talks. Don't say anything.
Okay.
Good day, welcome to our single. I'm Bob McKenzie, and this is my brother Doug. How's it going, eh? Beauty, eh?
Yeah, I like that.
Okay.
Okay, everyone, this record was my idea.
Get out!
It was.
You're lying.
Each post hit here just sort of rid on my coattails.
Why are you doing this? It was our idea together, eh?
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, okay.
We agreed to say that, but...
Oh, take off!
Yeah, it's good. Okay, so good day. Our topic today is music.
That's right, like, because my brother and I are now experts in the field,
yeah,
eh?
Right, because we're a band now. And,
yeah.
Well, so, except for him. I'm a band.
Oh, how can you do that, making me look bad? You're such a hose hand.
Yeah, well, take off!
Drum solo.
Okay, everyone, like, this is me on the drums,
oh,
eh?
Get out.
It is not.
It is so.
Stop
lying,
will you?
Take off, eh?
Oh.
Take off to the great white north. Take off. It's a beauty way to go. Take off to the great white north. Take off. It's a beauty way to go. Take off.
Beauty, eh? Like magic, eh?
Yeah.
Coming in.
Well, that's
like it was sung by angels.
Hey, hold on.
Yeah, what?
There's no way I'll ever do another record with you, Holder.
Yeah. Okay, that's fine. I'll do a solo album.
Fine, and you'll be looking for me
another label.
Now everybody's gone. Good day.
Good day.
So, like, take off to the great white north.
Beauty.
Take off. It's a beauty way to go. Take off, you hosers.
Hey, Geddy, we'd like to thank you for coming on the album and singing on the hit single.
Well, it was my pleasure, eh? Like, I wish you guys, like, lots of success and everything.
Beauty.
Thanks,
Geddy. A lot, eh?
Oh, that's great.
You're welcome.
Okay. Like, if we do another one, maybe you could do it?
Well, slow down, eh?
Okay. One at a time, right?
Don't push the guy,
yeah,
eh?
Yeah, okay. Sorry. But, you know, like, thanks for this one.
Thank you.
No sweat.
Yeah.
Good day.
Good day.
Good day. Good day.
Bob and Doug McKenzie from the Great White North with their guest Geddy Lee in the number two song on the Dr. Demento Funny Five, Take Off. Well, we got a little time for an extra now, so let's take off from the Great White North to the teeming Orient for a little bit of Monty Python.
The world today seems absolutely crackers, with nuclear bombs to blow us all sky high. There's fools and idiots sitting on the trigger. It's depressing, and it's senseless, and that's why I like Chinese, I like Chinese. They only come up to your knees, yet they're always friendly and they're ready to please. I like Chinese, I like Chinese. There's 900 million of them in the world today. You'd better learn to like them, that's what I say. I like Chinese, I like Chinese. They come from a long way overseas, but they're cute and they're cuddly and they're ready to please. I like Chinese food, the waiter's never a rude. Think of the many things they've done to impress. There's Maoism, Taoism, I Ching and chess. So I like Chinese, I like the Chinese for free. There's Zen, there's ping pong, there's yin and yang. I like Chinese thought, the wisdom that Confucius taught. If Darwin is anything to shout about, the Chinese will survive us all without any doubt. I like Chinese, I like Chinese. They only come up to your knees, yet they're wise and they're witty and they're ready to please. All together.
Whoa, I jump around. Whoa, I jump around. Whoa, I jump around. Ni hao ma, ni hao ma, ni hao ma da jian. I like Chinese, I like Chinese. Their food is guaranteed to please. A 14, a 7, a 9 and white cheese. I like Chinese, I like Chinese. I like their tiny little trees. Their zen, their ping pong, their yin and yangies. I like Chinese.
Monty Python with I Like Chinese from the Contractual Obligation album, an extra on the Dr. Demento Funny Five.
Why did Roger the Riveter stop chewing carefree and start chewing new and improved Chewels?
Chewels taste better.
Why did Terry the Tap Dancer stop?
Chewels taste better.
Why did Paul the Piano Player stop?
Chewels taste better.
New and improved Chewels is the only sugarless gum with a delicious flavor center. And test proof of leading sugarless gums.
Chewels taste better.
All right, Dimensions and Dementites, here we come to the biggest hit of the whole party. The number one song on the Funny Five is next.
It's time for number one. This is it. Here it comes. Number one.
Dead puppy. Dead puppies. Dead puppies aren't much fun. They don't come when you call. They don't chase squirrels at all. Dead puppies aren't much fun. My puppy died late last fall. He's still rotting in the hall. Dead puppies aren't much fun. No, no, no. Mom says puppy's days are through. She's going to throw him in the stew. Dead puppies.
Number one on the Funny Five on the Dr. Demento Show, Dead Puppies from the album Circus Royale. Number two was Take Off with Bob and Doug McKenzie all the way from the Great White North. And don't forget, Bob and Doug McKenzie going to be my very special guests under the smog fairy trees on next week's show. They're coming to take me away by Napoleon the 14th, who is number three, and Sarah Cynthia Sylvia Stout by Shel Silverstein, number four, and Punk Polka by the Tunes was number five. The Dr. Demento Show is a Westwood One production. Lindsay Guerrero is our associate producer. Norm Pett is our executive producer. Joe Selden is our engineer. Till next week when we do it again, don't forget to stay.